Hello, hello all. I see it's very busy here. Thank you all so much for joining. Oh, I'm a bit nervous. hey, for everyone who's new here, I'm Nepiki. I've been streaming for almost a year now, and I figured I would take it to the next step. That's all we're going to be doing today. I'm finally going to become a VTuber, I think, I hope, maybe. We'll see about that. Yeah, I figure we should just straight go up to the review, if you all don't mind. That's all we've been waiting for centuries, for years. Hello, Real Gamer with Glasses, glad to see you all as well here. Yeah, let's just straight get on to the review. So, give me a sec, I have to get dressed, so I'll be here in a bit. See these beautiful curtains. Hello, VK5 not to be. Oh, that totally didn't bust that. Okie do. Let me get dressed for a bit. Don't mind me. Oh yeah, this looks very good. This looks very good. Haha. Yes, okay. Okie do. Oh, wait, no peeking. No peeking. No peeking. I'm still changing. No peeking. I said no peeking! Oh, whoops. Ah, well, I'm changed anyway. Hello! Haha, that's not what you expected, wasn't it? Haha, it is me! Nepiki, the hamster! Oh, yeah. Yeah. I hope you weren't expecting this. If you were, then I'm sorry to not meet your expectations. yeah. Before I move on, I want to give a big shout out to two members in particular. Kotaku from my Discord server, who has helped me design the concept art. And Rayhan Josh on Twitter. I'll link his Twitter tag in the comments real quick. He offered to make my model and I graciously accepted. I'm very happy with that. So yeah, I hope that didn't actually tag someone else with the same name. Sorry about that. Alright, let's move on to the important stuff. Let's introduce myself a bit. Let's... Neat. Alright, let's go on. I'll try to focus on the comments as much as possible, but I'll, I'm kind of nervous, so I just mostly will be focusing on the review and stuff, so I'm going to be introducing myself bit by bit. So this is my new stream layout, welcome! And I'm in the bottom corner, oh yeah. Oh, yeah. This is my new layout, I'm in the middle of a sunflower field, isn't it beautiful? Because of course, I'm tired of sunflowers. Oh, and I got a new, would you look at that, subscriber notification, thank you so much VK4 5 OTB. I can't say that in English. I am too used to say that in Dutch. Anyway, so as you can see, there are actually two characters on screen right now, or three if you come in the bottom right as well. One of them is me, and the other one is also me. Yes, very confusing, I know. there's actually a reason behind that. There is a lore. I hope you all are very interested in hearing my lore. And I thought very hard of this. Please praise me. Anyway, let me read it up real quick. It was one fateful night in the change of millenniums, where the evil hybrid head god of sunflowers accidentally sneezed, turning Nepiki into a hamster when the controller is touched. The end. That's it. Please praise me. Please. But yeah, anyway, that's kind of the lore. The evil, hyper dead god of sunflowers sneezed, and now I'm a hamster whenever I game. Isn't that beautiful? Yes. For that reason, the age is also marked with ? Because hamsters usually don't get older than 3 years, and yeah, I kind of didn't want to turn this into a depressing stream, so yeah. but my birthday is on February 12th, figured I would mention that as well. Around that time I usually do a lot of celebrations, special games, whatever I can find, you know, all that stuff. And yeah, my occupation, I am a writer, a reviewer, that's what my humanoid self does when I'm not touching a game, because then it turned into a hamster, of course. I review games, the link is down there as well, nepicgaming.com. I won't be talking about it too much because we're here for the stream, but yeah. And I'm also a tester, I figured I would mention that. That's my other job when I'm not writing and when I'm not touching a controller. You know, the usual stuff. Real Gamer, thank you so much for the follow. Much appreciated. And testing my other... Alright, I figured I would move on to the languages. So, they're basically sorted on how fluent I can speak them. The first is Dutch, because of course I'm from the Netherlands, so that kind of makes sense. I speak this every day. Don't expect a stream in Dutch though, at least. I'm not planning on it myself. Maybe in due time, who knows. I don't have any plans right now. Then there's going to be the language that I will be focusing on, and that's probably going to get memes, because even though I will be speaking this language all the time, I cannot for the life of me actually mention the name of the language itself. So bear with me for a sec, please don't mean this. Thank you. English! Did I mention that correctly? Probably not. But yeah, that's what all the streams will be about, of course. Yeah, I also listed German and Japanese. These are both languages I can understand, but not fluently speak, so I probably won't be focusing on them unless someday I do a Japanese reveal stream or something, I don't know, you never know. But yeah, English, please don't mean that. I can't say the language, okay? I've been trying for years, please leave me alone, I've been trying so hard. I actually have a sad face for this. Yes, please don't meme it. Please don't. Alright, let's move on to the next part, because we have more to go. My favorite games and genres. I'm mentioning this specifically because then you can know what to expect from me, what the idea is of what will I be streaming. So I figured I would mention my three favorite genres, starting with JRPG. That was usually my favorite genre, but it's kind of being contested by Metroidvania right now, because I kind of love them a lot. And I've listed some games that I really love from that genre. The first one is Neon Falcom, and you might be questioning what the hell is a Neon Falcom. It's not a game. You are correct. And if I had a virtual cookie, you would definitely get a virtual cookie right now. I don't have a virtual cookie, so bear with me for a sec. But Neon Falcom, they make the Trails games, or the Kiski games, depending on what you prefer to call it. The East games, the Xanadu games, Brandish, more. They're basically my favorite companies, so if you ever see me talking about a game, it's probably them, and I definitely encourage you to play them. Then there's Tales of, a franchise I've been playing for years. Love the games. Favorite game is Crisis F. Berseria, love it. Symphonia. All this stuff. Give me a sec, I really need to drink some water for a bit. There we go. Final Fantasy actually has my favorite game of all time, Final Fantasy VI, but also Final Fantasy IX, the city of Final Fantasy, really love that franchise. I've been born with it, my first ever game was Final Fantasy, as some people may know. I haven't been keeping that a secret. We have Star Ocean. Now I'm kind of going into the lesser territories now, because who even knows Star Ocean? I am obscure, okay? Pokemon, I'll probably be doing that sometimes. Neptunia, because of course. My character is partially based on Neptune, and the other on Hibiki. We'll probably go more into detail on that on later time as well. Yeah, that's it for JRPGs. Of course, I love regular RPGs as well. I love my Elder Scrolls. I love my action RPGs. I love pretty much everything. And that's also with the Metroidvanias. Castlevania, of course, where the name originated, kind of. Half of it. Love my Metroidvanias, can play them whenever I want. Hollow Knight, fantastic game. Yoku's Island Express, very original. And Ori in the Blind Forest. As you might know, I didn't list Metroid, and that is for a specific reason, because I haven't played that many games in the franchise, except for like the first game and a few others. So I figured I wouldn't list them there, because I don't consider myself a big fan. That would kind of be offensive to actual fans. Yeah. Ah, we have a Star Ocean fan in the comments, thank you. Always good to see you. And then we have the platformer, also a genre I absolutely love. Collectathons, 2D, 3D, Sonic, the Hedgehog. Longtime fans also know that, because I've actually made a month of Sonic, and I've also... well, it's my favorite franchise, I have a lot of merchandise, a lot of games. I love it. Of course, Super Mario, you can't go wrong with that. Mega Man, you can't go wrong with that. Spyro, you can go wrong with that, but if you choose the right games, you can't go wrong with that. Rayman, that, but you can't go wrong with that. And yeah, that's basically my favorite genres, and I couldn't even mention something like the racing genre, because I love Burnout and Wipeout. The adventure genre, open world genre, Zelda, GTA, love them. Other games like Genshin Impact, Fate Grand Order. Genshin Impact is a game I stream quite a lot, and that I will also be streaming tomorrow. Yes. but I'll come back to that in due time, because actually we are going to cover the next part. Kinda. The stream focus! Yes! So, you are here. Hopefully for longer, and not just for now. Please stay. I love you. Thank you. If you do, I stream High Variety. I play obscure games, I play indie games, retro, modern, whatever you can find. No board games. No, probably board games as well. I play everything you like. Exactly. And that also kind of goes into hand with the final point of this beautiful picture that I've made. Yes. Patreon and Twitch subscribers, I still need to get everything to work, but they technically have a few benefits, like being able to vote on what game is next, so hint hint, wink wink, you know where to find me. Yes, exactly. As for other games, mostly I'll be focusing on first playthroughs, so games I've never played before. I'm doing that a lot. Sometimes I play games that I've played before, but usually when I do it for a marathon or for an anniversary. Like recently I've played through the first three Spyro games, because that was a marathon. I want to play all three of them back to back. I have another marathon in mind. Like I said, the Patreons kind of have an influence on that, so please vote for me. Thank you. Please don't vote the other entries, I'll probably make them bad. So you vote for the good one, thanks. Yes, exactly. Yes. My streams also have an emphasis on achievement hunting. I do that a lot, but I will clarify something right now. I am not a diehard achievement hunter, so if I see an achievement or if it's a terrible game, I probably just drop it or something, I don't know. That also goes hand in hand with retro games, because there's actually a site that... Oh, I need to drink again. Yes, very refreshing, thank you. There's actually a game fan-made site called Retro Achievements. I'll probably link that later as well. Where you can actually hunt retro achievements on retro games. It's kind of a gray zone, it's not exactly legal, especially if you get the ROMs with true piracy. So yeah, you didn't hear it here, but I can assure you that I do own all the games that I play, so yeah. And finally, the big point, something that I have been focusing on quite a lot, and something that I want to focus on quite a lot, randomizers, absolutely love them, Zelda Link to the Past is my also one of my favorite games ever, and playing that randomized, it's a whole different experience, I love it. I could play it again and again and again, and I'll probably play it again and again and again. Same goes for Yoku's Island Express, or even the Blind Forest, even though I kind of messed up there last time, but let's ignore that. Let's ignore that part. But yeah, randomizers, love them. So that's basically what you can expect from me. You can expect high variety, first playthrough, so you'll be experiencing it together with me. I probably won't know a lot. Achievement hunting, though it's not as big a focus as you might think, and randomizers. So, yeah. And I figured that I would also mention my other interests. These won't really be that important, because I won't be focusing on anime or music or anything else, but I figured if you want to know me, you better go all the way, I guess. And my favorite anime, I don't really watch that much anime anymore, I must admit. Like, probably like one season every 3 months, which is like one episode a week. Used to be a bigger fan of it, but yeah, sorry about that. But my first ever anime was... Well, no, not my first episode, sorry. My favorite anime ever is Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. Also really love Assassination Classroom, the Toari series, even though the anime is pretty much trash. the Magi series, please continue, and Fate. That big rabbit hole that I can't escape from, yes. love it. Also play Fate's Grand Order, yes, I know. I am a degenerate, sorry. And I also want to listen to music. I'm mostly a rock and metal head, so I listen to Guns N' Roses, Breaking Benjamin, Seether. Definitely my favorite bands. But usually when I listen to music, it's mostly cover artists or remixes, because I've heard Breaking Benjamin like way too much to want to get old. So I listen to guitarists like Richard E.B., K-Metal. They remix all kinds of game music. Cover artists like Jonathan Young and Caleb Hells. Figured I would mention them as well. And other VTubers as well, because I do listen to Japanese music. Pretty good stuff. And before you ask, I'm probably not going to be a cover artist myself, I'm sorry. Unless you absolutely love my voice, please let me know. I'll give it a try, maybe, I don't know. And other interests, Marvel movies, even though I'm way behind and I really need to catch up. Archie Sonic comics, they're part of the reason why Sonic the Hedgehog is my favorite franchise ever. Really good comics, absolutely recommend them. Mythologies, I focus on them a lot. That's also why I'm a big Fate fan, because, well, mythologies, history, all that stuff. Especially Norse, love that. I love my doggo. I don't have a doggo pick right now, and I'm so sorry again. And I love dragons, which I actually want a tattoo of, but I don't have that right now. that's a story for another day as well. Probably shouldn't derail too much from my debut. Okay, so finally, after this we're going to have a free chat, so don't worry, I'm not leaving yet. But finally we have the goals and plans what I have to do. So short term, I'm going to be updating the layout a bit, and the other assets, like, I did have an opening and ending, but yeah, they're before my VTuber career, so they're not exactly up to date anymore. you did already get a glimpse of my subscriber and follower notification. Beautiful, isn't it? Yeah, I love it as well. the next point is actually a bit more interesting. Learn how to make story-heavy games appealing, because, well, as I mentioned, my favorite genre is JRPG. But there are also like 40 to 80 hour long games with a lot of dialogue, and I kind of don't know how to make them interesting, so I want to make that a focus, see if I can make it interesting or not. We'll see. And finally, I also want to go a bit into my role as a hamster and actually incorporate hamchat in normal speech. Because, well, I have to do something to make myself stand out, right? And I do know the words, but I never use them in normal speech, like, yeah. that's kind of something I never do, so I kind of have to learn myself. Like, I do know the words, like, guess P, is that a mega cube banana in your pants, or are you busy to see me? Yeah. I do know all the words. I can go on, like, zoo, I don't know. I know everything. There's, like, 78 words. I'll be fine. I just need to learn how to use them in my dialogue, yeah. As for long term, I eventually want to go on to make a tier list Thursday, where I make a tier list on Tier Maker every Thursday. That's a long term plan. You probably won't be seeing that for a while, but if it will come, it will come, definitely. I'm hyped for that, so. Make achievements a bit more significant in terms of alerts, so I need to grab a big air horn whenever an achievement pops, and then I make you all deaf. So you know that I got an achievement. It's kind of important, you know. Also, I want to find an MMO to fall in love with again, because that's actually been a very long while. I haven't played an MMORPG in, like, way too long. Unfortunately, because I do love MMOs, but I just haven't found a game that keeps me hooked anymore. Like, my favorite MMORPG of all time is Guild Wars 2, but once I finish that game, I never return. RuneScape, I've played that for 10 years. 10 years? Probably not. And I am pretty much maxed on there. I have every skill to 99, so that's pretty much nothing I can do as well. So I kind of want to find a new one, and yeah. I've heard good stories about Final Fantasy XIV. I want to get back into the Elder Scrolls Online. Amazon is launching a new MMO for whatever reason, I don't know. Kind of, that trip to space wasn't enough for Jeff. He kind of wants an MMO as well. So yeah, that's also a long-term goal. Whenever I find an MMO, I'll try it out on stream, and we'll get to it together. And finally, some team months. A goal that I have in mind is to have some team months, like a month where I only play Game Boy games, or a month where I only play games like retro games, I don't know. Kind of like that. But that's also just work in progress. Of course, I need to focus on the site as well, so... I am a busy hamster when I'm not gaming. Then I'm a busy man. Yes, exactly. Alright, and that's kind of everything I had to say, so... Yeah. I hope you enjoyed the debut.